Welcome to another episode of The Daily Dose. I'm Tara Nichols, and today we're talking about living with anxiety, depression, bipolar disorder, or any other mental health disorder. Now, each mental health disorder has some very specific symptomology, very specific behavioral patterns, and has tendencies within the way the brain processes everyday information. The first thing you can do is move from a place of denial or a place of avoidance and move into a mindset of acceptance and understanding. Your brain is the most powerful organ in the body, and just like your liver or your heart or your lungs, it too can have tendencies. And so you can have a tendency towards a disorder pattern or symptomology of a disorder and live with it your whole life and not really give yourself the support and care you need. So I think it's very important, very first step is to learn how to embrace whatever tendency your brain has and how you process information, how you cope with stress, how you deal with daily life, relationship issues, work-related issues, financial stress, any other type of issue, that you learn to embrace how your brain processes that information and move to a place beyond judgment, beyond denial, beyond feeling negative about the way your brain processes information, and move to a place of understanding and acceptance. Stay emotionally flexible with yourself. This is a very hard one for me because I live with anxiety disorder, and I like to have things planned out. I like to project my future progress. I like to focus on productivity, and I live in a high stress lifestyle, and that helps me stay feeling powerful and in control. But with anxiety, that's also a trigger. So I have to learn how to stay flexible in my mindset, okay? You have to focus on your strengths. With every tendency, with every disorder, there are certain symptoms that are considered limitations or weakness or difficulty for that person and the way they process the world around them. But there's also strengths. And in each disorder, there are certain things that the brain does really well. And if we can stay focused on our strengths, we can use those strengths to leverage us towards living well. One of the things that you need to do is come up with a really good plan that allows you to stay in wellness. If you're needing help, going to a therapist is the perfect place to begin. Strategizing and learning how you can live well and creating a plan that works for you. But coming up with a plan for your mental health is definitely one thing that everyone should do. Everyone who has a brain should have a mental health strategy for how they're going to keep themselves well. So what are some of the things that you can do to structure your day, to structure your plans, to incorporate your mental health and your mental health needs? It's very common for us to ignore it, to push past it, to try to white knuckle our life and kind of bully ourselves into a place where we feel like we're normal. But the reality is that if we cultivated a plan that allowed our brains to receive the rest, the support, the love, and the care that we need, taking deep breaths, using mindfulness throughout our day, taking frequent rests, supporting our human connection by, you know, reducing our cell phone usage, taking jobs that are less stressful, strategizing our life to where we put our mental health and our own wellness first. Just find one thing that you can do to support your wellness today. Create and cultivate a plan around that one thing and incorporate one good change to your life every day. If you woke up and made a 5-degree change today, just one right thing to support your brain and to support your body. I hope this video is helpful. If you like this video, please click the subscribe button. For more information on mental health for everyday life, you can find me on Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn. Please take time to share this video with someone that you care about.
Thank you for watching, and see you next time on The Daily Dose.